And what was it about this story that made you want it to bring it to the big screen?
It reminded me of the movies I loved as a child growing up, Wizard of Oz, Star Wars, fantasy. It's so beautiful, and it just felt like something children would fall madly in love with, and adults too.
Sure they will. Now, can you just start by giving us a quick synopsis? What is Rise of the Guardians all about?
It's about the heroes of childhood who come together to protect the children of the world. This is the true story of the characters. Before, it's all just been what people have said. So this is who they really are. We did a lot of research. We met with them. This is actually who Santa Claus or North really is, and the Easter Bunny. He's an Australian warrior, and the Tooth Fairy is indeed a hummingbird. Well, for us, for North, he's Santa Claus. He's naughty and nice, so we figured, who's more naughty and nice than Alec Baldwin? You can't figure anybody else other than that. Jude, we thought he represents the boogeyman and fear, so you need somebody seductive and alluring and compelling, and that's Jude. Isla has her voice as a musical instrument, so to play a hummingbird is astoundingly perfect. And Sandman doesn't speak. He's the bringer of dreams, so it's left to your imagination. And Hugh Jackman is just the most perfect man on the planet. So the warrior who protects spring at the same time and is all about hope and joy. That felt like you. Chris Pine, we can't forget him. My Jack Frost, who is just the essence of mischief and fun and life, and he's just sort of the perfect person to play the role.
Those great voices are accompanied by some beautiful visuals. Can you talk a little bit about the visual inspirations for the film, the style of the animal?
The inspiration, again, goes back to sort of the beautiful movies, The Wizard of Oz, the red shoes that we all fell in love with. We wanted bright color. We had to create six worlds, and really we just went into our imagination and imagined all the possibilities for each world.
Is there a particular scene, a particular world that you personally enjoyed the most, you're most excited to bring to life on screen?
You know, I really love all of them, but I think the Tooth Fairy's world is really spectacular. It's just something you haven't seen before. And in 3D, it's amazing. You're entering sort of a palace in the air. It's pretty spectacular.
So much action, and it is in 3D. Were there any particular technical challenges making the film?
Yes, every day. I think just creating the visuals and creating the 3D animation with the Sandman effects and the nightmares and Pitch's world was really complicated. We had to create everything new. It's all brand new and never before seen technology, so quite a bit.
Do you think we might see more?
I hope so. If they fall in love with it, there will be more. Fingers crossed. That's my dream.
Final question. What are you hoping that little kids and big kids are going to both take away from this wonderful film you've made?
I hope that they really think that they spent 2 hours in a movie theater and saw their dreams come to life on screen.